Hello, my name is Jesse Lepak. I'm the Great Lakes Fisheries Specialist for New York Sea Grant. Today I'm going to demonstrate a method for treating barotrauma in yellow perch called venting or fizzing. The procedure involves puncturing the swim bladder of the yellow perch with a hollow tool to release some of the gas it contains. If done properly, this technique can relieve pressure on some of the yellow perch tissues and allows the fish to regain buoyancy. Please review the barotrauma fact sheet online at the New York Sea Grant website to learn more about barotrauma in yellow perch and how to recognize it. The fact sheet also considers some of the pros and cons of this method for treating barotrauma versus others. Please note, this is not an endorsement for this procedure, but if you ever find yourself in a situation where it is necessary, this is how to conduct the procedure to minimize potential harm to yellow perch. You'll need a clean, small gauge venting or fizzing tool. The tool should be hollow to allow gas to escape from the swim bladder. There are many different tools commercially available. Insert the tool only as far as necessary, and try to do this while holding the perch underwater in a live well, cooler, or bucket. That way you will see bubbles escape from the end of the hollow tool when the swim bladder is punctured. I'm using a stand-in today for demonstration purposes, but you must identify the position on the yellow perch where you will insert the venting or fizzing tool. In general, this can be done by allowing the yellow perch pectoral fin to spread out flat against the body of the fish. Count 3 to 4 scales back from just above where the fin extends the furthest, and insert the tool at a 45 degree angle between the scales. Release only as much gas as necessary to allow the fish to regain proper buoyancy and swim down from the surface on its own.